Yes.
You're so enthusiastic. You
beat me, I'll start the time.
Hello, everyone. Today, I will be sharing about a chemical imaging technology we developed to study the structure of collagen. This tool enables us to gain deeper insights into chemistry, including collagen-related diseases and treatments. Do you know what is the first part of your eye that helps you to see clearly? It is called the cornea, and it is the outermost layer of your eye's focusing system. On the molecular level, collagen helps to keep your cornea in shape. And actually, not just your cornea, collagen helps support many parts of your body, such as your skin, tissues, bones, and tendons. However, when the structure of collagen changes, your tissue changes shape, which leads to diseases. One such disease is called keratoconus. It is caused by structural changes in the cornea of your eye. As you can see here, keratoconus causes the cornea to bulge out and become disrupted. This leads to blurry vision. A simple treatment for keratoconus is applying vitamin B2 and UVA light to the cornea. However, the underlying mechanisms as to why and how this treatment works are still unknown. So our research group decided to approach this problem by developing a new imaging technology that can view the cornea at a chemical level. By imaging the collagen bonds, we can gain insights into the chemistry underlying this treatment. Previously, one of the best methods for imaging collagen was second harmonic generation, SHG microscopy. As seen in the top picture, we can see the collagen fibers that make up the cornea. The bottom image is a magnified portion of the collagen fibers. However, seeing the overall shape of the collagen fibers is not enough to understand the chemistry underlying this treatment. However, if we can view specific chemical bonds, then we can understand the chemical modifications happening during this treatment. So our research team developed sun frequency generation, also known as SFG microscopy. Unlike the previous SHG, SFG shines specific energies of light that match specific chemical bond vibrations. The SFG spectra on the right shows two peaks, red and blue. Each peak corresponds with a chemical bond vibration and the energy of light we need to use to excite it. The SFG image on the left shows two colors, red and blue. These correspond to the chemical bond vibrations shown in the SFG spectra. Now we can see so much more than just the overall shape of collagen fibers. We can image specific chemical bonds. Although this shows that we can image specific chemical bond vibrations, it does not tell us which ones we are looking at. So our next step is to identify which chemical bond vibrations we are imaging. To answer this question, we initially studied rat tail collagen, specifically the carbon hydrogen CH stretching vibrations. There are two possible vibrations, symmetric and antisymmetric. From SFG spectra, we know these correspond to the energies of light at 2,945 wave numbers and 2,882 wave numbers. But we do not know which is which. In order to figure this out, we need to use symmetry properties. From theoretical simulations, we discovered the symmetry properties for the two vibrations. One is a peanut shape and the other is a butterfly shape. From experimental measurements, we were able to determine the shapes for the two energies of light. 2,945 wave numbers showed a peanut shape, and 2,882 wave numbers showed a butterfly shape. Now we were able to match the energies of light to the corresponding chemical bond vibrations. Overlaying the symmetry properties, we can clearly identify which is which. 2,949 wave numbers shows a peanut shape, and 2,882 wave numbers shows a butterfly shape, and they just exactly match with the two vibrations. Piecing everything together, we have determined that we can see way more than just overall shape. We can image specific chemical bonds and see how they change during treatments. By applying this to keratoconus, we can see the chemical changes that happen during this treatment. Looking forward, SFG microscopy will help us not only better understand keratoconus, but also other diseases caused by structural changes in collagen. By looking at the level of chemical bonds and their vibrations, we can develop better treatments to help people see clearly and enjoy life to the fullest.